Good day to Puan Syuhada. My name is Nur Tariq Sofia binti Syamuddin. Number matric is 01DDT22F2032. And my friend is Muhammad Amirul Fitri, 01DDT22F2043. And Muhammad Adik Imran is 01DDT22F2053. Today we would like to present about our mini project, which is System Door Lock. For introduction, the advancement of Internet of Things IoT technology has paved the way for smart home solution that enhance security and convenience. Our project focuses on developing a smart door lock system utilizing the ASP32 microcontroller. The system integrates a servo motor, ultrasonic sensor, buzzer, LED and button to create a secure automated door lock solution. The primary goal is to provide an efficient, user-friendly and reliable method for home security. Next is problem statement. Traditional door locks are susceptible to various security risks such as picking and unauthorized key application. Additionally, manual locking mechanism can be inconvenient and prone to user error, potentially leaving the unsecure. There is a need for an advanced locking system that offers enhanced security features, user authentication and automation to address these vulnerabilities.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. My name is Muhammad Imran bin Muhammad Idora Jendret. And I'm from DDTN4, so I'm going to continue from the previous presentation from my friend. So next is I'm going to explain some of the objective that we have got based on the project Internet of Things that we already made. So the first objective is automatically locks and unlocks the door based on the proximity detection. The next objective is enhance security through an intelligent and automated locking mechanism. The third one is users will receive a warning when the buzzer sounds. And the fourth one is ensuring the system is user-friendly and easy to operate with a button interface. So the next one is I'm going to explain the function of component and device that we have used to create our project. So the first one is ESP32 microcontroller. The function is the central processing unit that control all the other component. The second one is servo motor, which is responsible for the physical unlocking and locking the door. The third one is ultrasonic sensor, used to detect someone's presence when close to the door. The next one is buzzer. The buzzer will sound when the servo motor activated to unlock the door. The next one is LED. So user can turn on the light on the fence manually so that the area will not look dark at the night. And the next one is button, which is allow user to manually control the button when the user want to turn on and turn off the light.
When the user is close to the door, the ultrasonic sensor will detect. When the ultrasonic sensor detects, the buzzer will sound. And the servo motor will move to open the door lock. After 2000 seconds, the servo motor will move again to close the door lock. The button works when it is pressed. The LED will light up and when the button is released, the LED will turn off. We also use the remote XY interface app to control the LED when we are outside the house. The LED will light up when the switch is on and the LED will turn off when the switch is off.
Hello, my name is Muhammad Amirul Fitri bin Muhammad Fikri. Number matric 01DDT22F2043. From class DDTN4. Okay, I will show the role of programming that we use in our mini project. I will explain in Malay. Okay, kat sini kita menggunakan coding yang kita ambil daripada remote SY. Lepas tu kat sini kita ada kita setkan kita punya hotspot name dengan dia punya password. Ni adalah server yang kita pakai, cloud.remotesy.com. Kita punya cloud port dan ini adalah cloud token. Okay, dekat sini kita memakai kat ASP32 server.h. Lepas tu kita tetapkan post, kita ada post LED, CM ni untuk ultrasonic dan buzzer. Okay, ini kita setkan kod untuk ultrasonic kita bagi dia punya function. Lepas tu kita define ini, define pin push ni kita punya untuk apa ni, button dalam kita punya app interface remote SY. Lepas tu kita masukkan remote SY ini, pin mode, kita punya button output. Lepas tu pin mode LED kita gak output, masa buat tu kita punya servo motor, setkan 25 dia punya pin, sorry pergi 9600, pin mode buzzer output. Okey kat sini, okey kita tunjukkan kita punya apa ni button. Ini adalah kod daripada remote SY. Okey kat sini kita tekan button digital rate dia, dia punya pin dia 26. Lepas tu kita strip print line button state. Okey kat sini kita buat if button state sama dengan 1, maksudnya button state tu on lah. Jika button state tu kita tekan, kita press, lampu akan menyala. Lepas tu delay 1000 second dia akan off balik. Ni, jika kita lepaskan dia akan, lampu akan tutup. Okey. Lepas tu kita juga ada setkan kita punya ultrasonic punya pengiraan. Ini 18 adalah trigger pin dan 19 adalah echo pin. Okey. Lepas tu kita set juga jika ultrasonic detect objek atau benda bawah 3 cm, dia akan mengeluarkan buzzer akan mengeluarkan bunyi dan juga servo motor akan bergerak untuk buka lock lah. Selepas 2000 second servo motor akan bergerak balik untuk menutup lock tersebut. Itu saja programming yang kami guna untuk projek ini. Okay, for the solution from our mini project, according to a real world social and environment problem, this project tackles the social issue of home security by utilizing an ultrasonic sensor for intruder detection, a buzzer for instant alert, a servo motor for secure locking, and a remote control LED via an app. For the environment problem, providing enhanced safety and promoting energy efficiency and material reduction. That's all from our group. Thank you.